"This needle is quite useless for sewing now," said the fingers. But they still held it fast, and the cook dropped some sealing wax on the needle and fastened her handkerchief with it in front. "So now I am a breastpin," said the Darning Needle. "I knew very well I should come to honor some day. Merit is sure to rise." And she laughed quietly to herself, for, of course, no one ever saw a Darning Needle laugh. And there she sat as proudly as if she were in a state coach, and looked all around her. "May I be allowed to ask if you are made of gold?" she inquired of her neighbor, a pin. "You have a very pretty appearance, and a curious head, although you are rather small. You must take pains to grow, for it is not everyone who has sealing wax dropped upon him." And as she spoke, the Darning Needle herself drew up so proudly that she fell out of the handkerchief right into the sink, which the cook was cleaning. "Now I am going on a journey," said the needle, as she floated away with the dirty water. "I do hope I shall not be lost." But she really was lost in a gutter. "I am too fine for this world," said the Darning Needle, as she lay in the gutter. "But I know who I am, and that is always some comfort." So the Darning Needle kept up her proud behavior, and did not lose her good humor. Then there floated over her all sorts of things, chips and straws and pieces of old newspaper. "See how they sail," said the Darning Needle. "They do not know what is under them. I am here, and here I shall stick. See, there goes a chip, thinking of nothing in the world but himself, only a chip. There's a straw going by now. How he turns and twists about! Don't be thinking too much of yourself, or you may chance to run against a stone. There swims a piece of newspaper. What is written upon it has been forgotten long ago, and yet it gives itself airs. I sit here patiently and quietly. I know who I am, so I shall not move.